What's happening?
I don't know. Unless, tomorrow's newspaper. Do you still have it?
Yeah. Local accountant beaten. Left for dead.
Local accountant Arthur McFly was severely beaten and left for dead on the steps of the Hill Valley Courthouse last night.
They're gonna kill my grandpa?
Tannen's goons, no doubt. Probably in retaliation for Arthur answering that subpoena you delivered.
What are we gonna do?
I'm not sure what we can do. According to this, your grandfather was dumped on the doorsteps of the courthouse 5 minutes ago.
My dad's picture is disappearing.
That's the time stream catching up with your grandfather's fatal wounds. Which means your father will never be born, and neither will you, unless... When did you last see your grandfather?
4 o'clock, in the town square.
Let's give him enough time to make his deposition.
Right.
We'll have to be careful not to run into ourselves.
That shouldn't be a problem in your case. I mean, you were in jail.
All right, let's get moving before the police find us.
Freeze! Step out of the car with your hands up. What was that?
What was what?
Crap! I heard something back there.
I think you're mistaken, officer.
Well, looks like I caught me a fugitive. Carl Sagan, the speakeasy arsonist.
Alleged speakeasy arsonist, if you don't mind.
What the heck kind of buggy is that?
Stay back. It's a prototype, still untested, liable to blow up at any moment. Or suddenly take off without warning.
That's so. There it is again.
I think the night air is playing tricks on you, officer.
What is it, some kind of foreign job? German or something?
Not at all. This is solid American workmanship.
Huh. Now I'm sure something's back there. Looks like something out of Buck Rogers.
A year from now, everybody will be driving these babies. Hey! Stop!
Doc!
No! Save your grandfather! I'll be fine until you get back.
You got it, Doc.
What was that?
.455. Artie's gotta be in there somewhere, spilling his guts to the DA. There he is! All I gotta do is get to him before...
Mr. Corleone! I was wondering if I could do a little follow-up interview with you about the plight of poor Mr. Sagan. My sources indicate that Judge Brown will be setting him free tomorrow.
I wouldn't bet on that.
What's that?
Nothing. Listen, can we talk later? I've really gotta get to the courthouse right now.
Really? Why?
My grandpa needs me as a character witness to get a fishing license.
Oh, well then, carry on. And do put that vicious dog of yours on a leash, will you? We have laws about that sort of thing, you know.
Sure, no problem. Oh, come on, yesterday, Marty. Stop talking, get moving. Einstein? Einstein, what is it, boy? Go away, boy! Crap! Einstein! Is it a squirrel, Einie? You want to play? Okay, let's play. Go get her, Einie. You!
Oh! Get this mangy animal away from me!
Come on, Einstein. Get away from the nice lady.
My shoes!
Einstein, no!
No!
Way to go, Einie. Now to get into that courthouse and grab Artie before Tannen's guys.
Hey!
Oh, God. Hey!
According to my calculations, the rotary engine for a full-scale rocket drill requires 1.21 kilowatts of power. Can you check over my work to make sure? Are you all right?
Yeah. Yeah. But I need to get to Arthur.
Why?
I have to brief him on what to say to the DEA.
Oh, are you the legal expert now? Come on. Shouldn't we be getting on with our work? We're on a strict deadline, right?
Sure. You start without me. Turn around and start walking, and I'll catch up to you in just a few minutes.
Huh?
Oh, hell. Oh, my God! What the hell is that?
What's what?
Who are you talking to?
I'm talking to you.
No, I mean before, while I was walking towards you.
I wasn't talking to anyone. I was working on equations for my rocket drill.
No, I mean after. Never mind. Let's get going.
Follow me.
I thought I'd never leave. At least now I have a clear shot to the courthouse. You gotta come with me. Look, you're in a lot of danger.
What do you mean I'm in danger?
No time to explain, Gran. Oh, Artie, just promise me you'll stay at the police station until...
Artie McFly. Just the guy we're looking for.
Hey, fellas.
Run! Get him!
Artie? I better pick up their trail before I start fading out again.
Looks clear.
All right, McFly. Let's go see the boss.
Buddy, how's my favorite accountant doing?
Oh, I've been better. Oh,
I'm so sorry to hear that, McFly. Trixie, take a powder, doll. We got business to discuss.
K.O., you boys play nice now. Mwah! Nice to see you again, Artie.
You too, Miss Trotter.
Yeah, we're all happy as clams. Now scram! Are you guys stupid? What are you thinking, bringing this fish food to my doorstep?
We just thought...
That was your first mistake. Thinking. Look at me. Do you ever catch me thinking? Huh? Don't answer that. Look, just drag him inside, find out what he told the DA, then get rid of him.
I think we can handle that.
Good. Now, if you don't mind, I've got an arsonist to snuff out. And will one of you slobs start hauling these crates in?
We're on it, kid.
So far, so good. Huh! I better get in there quick. Contents. one-winged goddess. Oops. Nice fit. Here goes nothing.
Get the crinks, cue ball. Stir the soup, cue ball. Clean out the bloodstains, cue ball. Shit, I'm not a gangster, I'm a freaking butler. Now, which one of you guys goes in first?
Jeez, for a gal with no arms, you sure is heavy!
Whoops.
Ow! Do you mind? I'm trying to conduct a professional interrogation over here.
Where should I put this?
Just shove it behind the bar.
I'll just shove you behind the bar.
Come on, Artie. Jeez, how much chloroform'd you put on that rag anyway?
Why?
Because I'm having a hard time bringing Sleeping Beauty here around.
Let me see. Hey, Artie! We got a few questions about you and the D.A.
D.A.
You see what I'm working with here?
Seems to be catching.
Zane, wake up!
Oh, sorry, boss. This stupid cold's got me wiped out.
Well, try to stay awake long enough to finish that poster, will ya? We got a club to open in a few days. And turn off that sign, would ya? Wake up, sleepyhead.
A combination to a lock?
Come on, Artie, wake up. You're sleeping your life away. Literally.
Whew. No wonder Artie's so out of it.
Hey, guys. I don't feel so...
Zane, wake up, you lazy bum!
Must have been the cold.
Cold my eye. He's been dipping into the inventory.
The inventory?
One more on down. Two to go.
This is gonna be the swellest speakeasy in Hill Valley.
It's gonna be the only speakeasy in Hill Valley.
Oh, right. Funny how the competition sort of,
died out. Hey!
Hey!
What was that?
Must be some wiring problems with the emergency button. I hope the Sisters of Mercy approve of our redecorating.
Oh, God. You're trying my patience, Artie.
McDermott's Canadian whiskey.
What the?
I think we blew a fuse.
Well, go up to the soup kitchen and get a new one.
Why me?
You'd rather hang around and talk to this guy, huh?
Happy days are here again.
Yeah, I'll just get that fuse.
Come on, Artie, wake up. You're sleeping your life away. Literally.
Bam! Right in the kisser. Hey, you. Wait, do I know you?
Not for about 40 years.
Is anyone down there?
Everything's spinning.
Come on, Artie. Let's get out of here before these jerks get a chance to kill you.
Wait a minute. They were gonna kill me?
Great.
This isn't funny, guys. Is anyone down there?
Perfect timing. Hang on, Grandpa. We've got a pickup to make. Need a lift?
I thought you'd never ask. What's he doing here?
It's a long story.
Ah, son of a...
And then I carried Artie to the DeLorean and came back to get you.
Fascinating.
So we can go home now, right?
Not yet. We still have this loose end to tie up.
No, don't tie me up again.
He's coming around.
So please be careful. You won't be safe in Hill Valley as long as Kit Tannen remains at large.
Don't worry, I'm going far away from Hill Valley, and I'm never coming back.
No! He's got to hook up with Grandma.
What's her name?
It's Sylvia.
You know a woman named Sylvia?
No.
Well, she knows you. We'll know you. It's vitally important that you two meet.
Oh, I get it. You want me to be part of some undercover sting operation.
No, possibly.
Yeah. Are you G-Man?
Uh-huh.
Something like that.
Sure, anything for Uncle Sam. I'll stay nearby and wait for this Sylvia. But in the meantime, I'll lay low.
Good man.
When can I expect to see you again?
That was a close call.
You think he'll be okay?
You're not fading out, are you? Besides, Arthur will be completely out of danger come August 25th.
August 25th?
That's the date Kit Tannen is finally put behind bars. How's that picture of your dad?
Still there.
Good. Let's get out of here before we accidentally elect Hoover to a second term.
Well, everything looks okay.
Are you sure?
See, McFly residence. So, want to come in? Maybe hang out a while? I want my dad to see for himself that you're still around.
I'd love to, Marty, but...
You've got
to
go. I understand, Doc. You've got a life to lead, kids to raise and all that.
No, I've got to go to the bank and stop that estate sale you told me about.
Oh.
You go find your pop. I'll be back within the hour.
See you soon, Doc. All right. Hey, anyone home? There's something wrong with my key.
Please, not now. Tomorrow. Give me another day.
Another day? Dad, what are you talking about?
Marty? No, that's impossible. Marty was run out of town.
I've got a bad feeling about this. Run out of town? What are you talking about, Dad? Let me in!
This is a trick. Go away!
Leave us alone! Haven't we suffered enough?
Mom? Mom, it's Marty, Mom! Open up!
It sounds like Marty. It must be a trick.
Mom!
Go away! Shame on you!
How can I convince you?
Tell me something only Marty would know.
When I was eight years old, I set fire to the living room rug.
That's right.
Oh, my Lord. What are you waiting for, George? Let him in.
Stupid locks.
Marty!
Oh my God, Dad! What happened to you?
What do you think happened, butthead?
Biff!
I thought we told you to stay out of town, shrimp!
Biff, whatever's going on, I'm sure we can handle it. Reasonably. Who are they?
Yeah, like you don't know Cliff and Riff.
What do you think we should do with them, baby bro? What we should have done years ago, big bro.
Oh, I'm gonna enjoy this, McFly.
Wait, I'm trying to process here. What the hell did you do to my dad?
Your dad's been in that wheelchair since before you were born, butthead.
And you better hope he has a spare, because you're going to need one in like 3 seconds.
Ugh. I got a question. What are you guys doing here anyway?
It's that time of the month. Time for Georgie to pay up.
Well, we usually take the payment in cash. But this month, we can take it out of your hide.
Ooh. Hey!
And another thing. Look, can't we bury the hatchet already?
Even better idea. I bury this 9-iron up your backside.
Tell me. How long have you been coming down on my dad like this?
Ever since that school dance, when Georgie laid Biff out in the parking lot.
Shut up, it's not funny.
Someone messes with the Tannen family never lets him forget about it.
Here's what I still don't understand. Why can't you pick on somebody else?
We do! We pick on lots of guys.
It's kind of our thing.
Biff! So now the Tannens are some kind of minor league mafia?
Hey, watch who you're calling minor league.
The Tannen gang's the fifth most dangerous crime family in California. We got connections all over the place.
No way.
You don't believe me?
Biff, no!
Bang! Check it out.
To your family from mine, in gratitude for your continued service, J.J. Valenti.
That's Don Valenti, godfather of the Sacramento mob.
The third most dangerous crime family in California.
Piece of cake.
I never should have let that floozy talk me out of rubbing out your grandfather.
Huh? Kid?
No one in Hill Valley messes with the Tannen family.
Doc! Marty, get in. This timeline's been compromised.
No kidding.
Somehow, something we did in 1931 allowed Kid Tannen to escape his date with justice. As a consequence, the Tannens have been unchecked in Hill Valley for over 50 years.
Ah, jeez, they robbed the arcade?
We've got to go back to the day Kid Tannen was supposed to be arrested. Figure out what went wrong and fix it. Otherwise, you could be forever stuck in a town owned by the Tannens.
Not an option, Doc. Punch it. Okay, Doc. Let's run through this again.
Sometime tonight, Kid Tannen is supposed to be betrayed by his mole, a singer named Trixie Trotter.
That hot babe I saw coming out of the speakeasy.
Exactly. When she does, history says Tannen will be arrested by a rookie cop by the name of Danny Parker.
Parker. Hey, do you think he's related to Jennifer Parker? My girlfriend?
Could be.
Heavy.
In any event, somehow we've changed history so that neither of these events happens. Condemning your family to generations of abuse at the hands of the Tannen crime family. You need to go back into Tannen's speakeasy. Find out what's gone wrong and get Kid Tannen arrested.
No problem, Doc. Let me just put on my hat and I'm good to go. Is the mustache really necessary?
It's essential. You can't let Kid know that you're the same troublemaker that foiled his attempt to kill me.
Are you sure you can't come in with me?
It's far too dangerous. You may be easy to disguise with your nondescript features, but ever since my daring escape from the police and the mob, my distinctive face has been plastered over every paper from here to Reno.
Nondescript?
I'll find a safe place to hunker down. That flop house ought to fit the bill. You can find me there if you need me.
Pardon me, sir. From the way you're dressed and your general aura of seediness, I can infer only one thing. You're heading for Tannen's speakeasy. Am I right?
No.
At least you possess enough shame to lie about it. Unfortunately, I don't have the power to stop you, but I beg you to tarry here a few more seconds and listen to my song. Me, 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 me. You say you've lost your self-respect, but you should care. What in heaven's name?
Oh, sorry, Miss Strickland. Just a little experimental prototype gone momentarily awry.
Mr. Brown, why is there a dog in that vehicle?
Why? Well, to advance the human condition, of course. Hello, Mike.
Mike? Mr. Corleone, what are you doing in that getup?
It's just my new look. I'm trying to prove that you can dress like a gangster without being a gangster, you know?
How exciting! You'll have to give me an exclusive sometime. Right now, I've got some souls to save.
And you'll have to get an eyeful of my newest experiment.
You're not angry about the rocket drill?
Water over the bridge. I've moved on to bigger and better things. Come by the gazebo when you get a chance. I'll be setting up. You won't believe what Einie and I have been up to.
Famous last words. All right. Now where's that speakeasy?
Who sent you?
Ulysses S. Grant.
What did you bring me?
Meat and potatoes.
What's the word?
Words are for wimps.
Who told you to come here?
Doris Day?
Take a hike, squirt. Who told you to come here?
The old gray mare?
Who said you were worthy?
Hieronymus Bosch?
Who died and made you boss?
Boss Hogg?
What will you do if I let you inside?
Sidle up to your boss?
Where you born?
Borneo.
Welcome to El Kid, sir.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's my pleasure to once again present the hottest little number this side of the Rockies. And when I say my pleasure, I think y'all know what I'm talking about, am I right? So let's have a big L Kid welcome for the one, the only, Trixie Trotter.
They say I'm crazy, got no sense, but I don't care. They may or may not mean offense. But I don't care.
Out of my way, kid. I got some sorrows to drown.
I am my own superintendent. My star is on the ascendant. That's why I don't care. I don't care. I don't care.
Louis the Louse, squashed in his prime. Bucktooth Langley, bit off more than he could chew. Chuckles Lenard, he didn't get the last laugh. Hey, bartender.
What'll it be?
I'll have a drink.
What's your poison?
Peps. On second thought, forget it.
Suit yourself.
So about this, portrait gallery of yours.
What about it?
What's it all about? Who are those guys?
The caricatures hanging along the wall of honor commemorate those who are no longer with us on account of having ticked off one Irving Kid Tannen.
They're the guys the kids killed?
Well, of course not. They're just a bunch of guys that Kid didn't particularly like and that at a later date turned up dead. It's a circumstantial coincidence. Yeah.
What are you drawing?
Another celebrity caricature.
You drew those?
Prohibition ain't gonna last forever, bub. I gotta have a skill I can fall back on when all this goes away.
Think you could do a caricature of me?
Sure. Presto!
That really doesn't look like me.
I didn't have much to work with.
I'm looking for a cop named Parker.
Then this is your lucky night. He's sitting next to you.
Him?
Yep. Quite a sob story, that guy.
Sob story?
Oh, yeah. Job troubles, dame troubles, psychiatric troubles, you name it. You get him in the right frame of mind, he'll talk your ear off about him.
Thanks for the talk.
Next time, order a drink. This ain't no library, you know.
Hey, I know you. You're...
Parker. Osfer Danny Parker. Hill Valley PD. Have we met? You look familiar.
Nah.
Well, stranger, sit down and have a drink on me.
I hear you've been having troubles.
Troubles? Buddy, nobody knows the troubles I've seen.
Want to talk about them?
Do I? Do I? Yeah, I do. Listen, it all started when this car...
Every morning, every evening, ain't we got fun? Not much money, oh, but honey, ain't we got fun?
Whoopee!
Yeah, now about those troubles.
I don't want to wallow in misery. I came here to get happy. Hallelujah! In
the winter, see you later, Danny.
I'll be here.
I'm supposed to get this guy to arrest Kid Tannen tonight? Still we have fun. There's nothing surer. The rich get rich and the poor get children. In the meantime, in between time, ain't we got fun. Excuse me, are you Trixie Trotter?
That's what it says on my dressing room door. At least, it would if I had a dressing room.
I really like your voice.
Thanks. You should hear me when I ain't so under the weather.
You're sick?
Oh yeah, sore throat. That's why I'm giving Q-Ball so many extended solos tonight.
I kinda wondered about that. Hey, your songs seem to have a big effect on Officer Parker over there.
I am humbled and gratified that my musical gifts have fallen upon such receptive ears.
I don't care. What are those? Are they lyrics for one of your songs?
I haven't memorized them yet.
What's a nice gal like you doing with a guy like Tannen?
Kid ain't so bad. He just takes some...
Hey, Toots, any chance you could sing that can-can number? The guys really love the way it shows off your, assets.
Whatever you say, kid.
And quit lazing around. I ain't paying you to yak with the drunks.
You ain't paying me at all, you bum. What were we talking about again?
You were telling me what a great guy Kid is.
Yeah, I guess he is a pretty crummy boyfriend. But until my insurance policy checks out, I guess I'm stuck with him.
Insurance?
Yeah, look. I may not be the brightest bulb in the marquee, but even I know you don't break up with a creep like Kid without something to keep him from going all crazy on you.
What's this insurance policy all about?
Are you kidding? There's only one person I trust with my secrets, but I ain't seen him in weeks.
You don't mean...
Artie McFly.
Artie McFly.
You know him?
Not as well as I thought.
Before he took a powder, Artie was tutoring me in all sorts of stuff. Etiquette, philosophy, accounting. He's a regular Renaissance man. He even had one of those smart guy professor's pipes, see?
Can I borrow this?
Sure. I've been secretly working on my get-out-of-kid card for weeks now, but Artie's the only one I trust to check my work. You can't be too careful when you're dealing with a maniac like Kid, you know.
Hey, if I arrange a meeting with Artie, could you use that insurance of yours?
Use it? Heck, if what I'm sitting on pans out, I could send that bozo all the way to the big house.
I'll see what I can do. Break a leg out there.
Thanks.
She's supposed to turn on Kid Tannen tonight? Okay, Doc, if you say so.
Hey, nice suit. Where'd you get it?
Costume shop at the mall. I had it custom made.
Yeah? Quality material. Who are you? Where you from?
The name's, Michael Corleone. Nobody. I mean, you don't know me. I come from a very different place.
Come on. What's the dope? Spill it, or I'll...
Go easy, kid. From the cut of the suit, I'm thinking he might be with the Valenti gang.
Is that so?
Yes?
Prove it. You ain't leaving till you show me some bona fides.
I've got a little something here that might convince you.
Don't even blink.
It's not a real gun. It's not a real gun, I swear. It's a gift from Don Valenti. See?
To your family from mine, in gratitude for your continued service, J.J. Valenti. Looks like little Mikey Corleone here really is with the Sacramento boys. You got stones, Pee-wee. I like that. Have yourself a drink. On the house. Matches. Put down your gun. You look like a moron.
Hey, Artie. He's back. Hey, Edna.
Mr. Corleone, what can I do for you?
What are you doing out here in the middle of the night?
Saving people from alcohol, vice, and disorder. And also keeping a lookout for hot stories. You'd be surprised how much news breaks on this corner.
Broken any stories tonight?
Only the usual. Mayor Thomas trying to slink out of the speakeasy. Frankie Needles crashing his car into a fire hydrant. Nothing that'll get me the front page.
What was that song you were singing earlier?
Do you like it? I wrote it myself. It really gets the toes tapping at the Stay Sober Society meetings. Although I suppose that could be the shakes. Would you like to hear it again?
Maybe later.
I'll be here all night.
Do you think I could have a copy of your You Should Care lyrics? I've got a club of my own that could really use some inspiring.
Sure. Let me just get a page out of the hymnal. There you are.
Hey, thanks. You know, Trixie Trotter sings a song that sounds a lot like your You Should Care.
She does?
Yeah, but hers is a little more carefree.
That's what you get when you sing for booze hounds and gangsters.
What's going on with you and Emmett? The last time I saw you, you seemed to be kind of interested in him.
That was before I belatedly realized that his agreement to host my Stay Sober Society was a clever ruse to ferry barrels of hooch to his so-called laboratory.
Sorry about that.
Now his very presence fills me with an irrepressible urge to pick at his philosophical and intellectual foundations with every tool in my vocabulary.
So you're not dating?
Dating? The mere thought of romantic involvement with that undisciplined techno-anarchist is preposterous.
Good. Do you know anything about Officer Danny Parker?
Parker? Just another soul lost to the twin vices of booze and despair. I've asked him to tell me his story for my column. Sort of a cautionary tale, but he's never in the mood to talk to me.
You wouldn't happen to know anything about Trixie Trotter, would you?
Kid Tannen's latest conquest? Well, she claims to be a lounge singer from Seattle, but my sources in Washington have never heard of her. I mean, honestly, Trixie Trotter, what kind of name is that?
What have you got against dogs, anyway?
They're smelly, rude, completely unable to take care of themselves, and frankly, they're not very bright. If I had my druthers, dogs would be banned from public places.
Harsh.
It's a harsh world, Mr. Corleone.
What's Kid Tannen been up to for the last 2 months?
Didn't you hear? It was in all the papers.
I've been, traveling.
Well, the feds were all set to arrest Tannen on tax evasion charges. Seems they'd gotten Tannen's books from his accountant.
I heard something about that, yeah.
Well, the accountant disappeared, unsurprisingly. But the feds still thought they had a case. After all, they still had the books, right?
Right.
Wrong. The day before the trial, the books up and vanished right out of the court's evidence locker.
No.
Lots of fingers were pointed, but honestly, the whole town's so corrupt that it could have been anyone. Court clerks, cops, janitors.
So kid's walking around free?
Free, clear, and laughing it up in his new speakeasy. The feds want to bring a case up against him, but without those books, they've got nothing.
Couldn't kid be brought up on other charges like, say, running a speakeasy?
In a perfect world, yes. But no one in town seems to care about prohibition anymore. The feds are only interested because of the lost tax revenue.
Whatever happened with that speakeasy arsonist?
I was about to ask you the same question.
Me?
Don't play coy with me. I may not have any journalistically acceptable proof, but I know you had a hand in Carl Sagan's daring escape from the authorities.
Didn't you think that Sagan was innocent?
I used to, but after he escaped, 2 more speakeasies were torched in Colfax and Georgetown.
That's just a coincidence.
Coincidence? Or is our friend Carl a serial arsonist?
See ya.
Keep fighting the good fight!
Mike, you're just in time.
Have you been, Emmett? I know I haven't seen you in a couple of months.
I'm great, and I owe it all to you!
Really?
Yes, that argument I had with my father during our jet drill experiment gave me the incentive to finally quit that dreary court job. I've committed myself full-time to a life of science!
So, thanks for watching Einstein while I've been... away.
It's been a pleasure. He's proven to be a surprisingly willing test subject. It's almost as if he's been working with me for years.
More like decades. What's the story with the little car and all this equipment?
Einstein and I are conducting a few experiments with this 1/4-scale model to work out a few hitches in my planned demonstration at the Hill Valley Expo in a couple of months.
A radio-controlled car?
No. Well, yes, but that'll be so much more than that. It will amaze the world. Aha! Got it!
Got what?
I'll show you. Ready to go, Einstein? Watch this! When this baby hits 23 miles per hour, you're gonna see some serious cow flop.
Einstein!
No!
Get him out of there!
Not to worry. I've got a fail-safe eject mechanism around here someplace. See? Nothing to worry about.
Nothing. I'll go see if I can find something to help. Or someone. Hey, Doc. How's the room?
It's a little cleaner than I would have imagined for a depression-era flophouse. How are your investigations going?
I saw him.
Who?
My grandpa, on his streetcar for just a second. Doc, we gotta find him.
Why?
Trixie thinks she's got something that could put Kid away, but Artie's the only one who can tell her for sure. I guess he's kind of her tutor or something.
Ah, so that's the connection. When your grandfather disappeared from Hill Valley for 2 months, the bond between him and Miss Trotter was severed, eventually leading to a timeline in which Trixie lost the nerve to betray Tannen.
Yeah?
We've got to find your grandfather.
Any sign of Artie?
Haven't spotted him yet.
Are you sure Tannen's supposed to be arrested by Officer Parker? The guy's a mess.
Mess or no mess, I'm absolutely certain that Parker's your man. In fact, it's his arrest of Tannen that will eventually lead him to become Hill Valley's chief of police.
That seems really unlikely. Why didn't you tell me I'd run into your younger self tonight?
Because I don't remember being out here tonight. Clearly, your interactions with my younger self 2 months ago have slightly altered my personal timeline. I never have the nerve to perform public experiments like he's doing. No matter. Those experiments will be forgotten once I've seen Frankenstein.
Frankenstein?
Yes. Right now, my younger self is fiddling around out there with rocket propulsion systems for his demonstration at the expo.
The thing that'll kick off your scientific career.
Exactly. Now, the rockets are a horrible idea, and I'll soon realize that they'll never work. But eventually, I'll wander into that movie theater and see Frankenstein and clear my mind. I've kept the ticket stub from that movie in my wallet ever since. See?
Why?
Because it's during this movie that I'll have the inspiration for my breakthrough at the expo.
It doesn't have anything to do with reanimating the dead, does it?
Not the way you're thinking, no. But during that famous scene when Colin Clive turned the wheel that raised that shrouded figure into the tower, and that bolt of lightning struck, well, let's just say more than one brain was reanimated that night.
Emmett's not having much luck getting Einstein off the courthouse.
I'm not surprised. Einie's a smart dog, but heights give him the willies.
What can we do?
I've got it.
What?
Just get my younger self distracted, and I'll handle the rest.
Where'd you park the DeLorean?
I hid it in the DeSoto lot. Nobody's buying cars these days, so it should be safe in there.
Hey, who did burn down Tannen's original speakeasy anyway?
I still don't know. I'd really like to find out before we go home.
I never did get a straight answer about why he came back to 1931 in the first place.
It's, personal. When this is over, I'll tell you all about it.
I'm gonna hold you to that, you know. Can you explain all this? I'm confused.
It's very simple. In the original timeline, Timeline A, the speakeasy arsonist was never caught, creating one of Hill Valley's enduring historical mysteries.
Okay.
When I travel back to 1931, I created Timeline B, in which I was misidentified as the arsonist and subsequently killed by Kit Tannen's goons. Einstein came with me, and somehow he ended up in the DeLorean when its failsafe mechanism triggered, sending it back to 1986.
Which is where I came in.
Precisely. You traveled back to June 14th, 1931, creating Timeline C, a world in which Carl Sagan wasn't rubbed out by Kit Tannen. But Arthur McFly was served with a subpoena.
And shot by Kid Tannen's goons.
Yes. So you jumped back in time 6 hours, creating Timeline D, saving your grandfather's life, but somehow preventing Kid Tannen from meeting his date with justice.
Which is why the Tannens were so powerful when we jumped back to 86.
Uh-huh. So now we've returned to August of 1931, creating Timeline E, in which, fingers crossed, we'll send Tannen to prison where he belongs. Got it?
Sure.
Good.
One question.
What?
Can you explain all this? I'm confused. Okay, I better get back to fixing history.
Be careful, Marty.
Edna!
What?
Hey, I got a hot lead for you.
Oh? What is it?
Young scientist strands dog on courthouse roof.
What?
Look over there.
Oh, for goodness sake. Mr. Brown!
Please, Miss Strickland, not now. Can't you see I've got a rather delicate situation on my hands at the moment? My trial run...
Trial run? Public hazard, I call it. And I'm sure my editor will agree. This scientific enterprise of yours represents a clear and present danger to public safety.
You know what represents a clear and present danger to public safety? Your singing voice.
There's no need to get personal, Mr. Brown.
Believe me, I have no intention of getting personal with you.
I'm relieved to hear it. Flying cars, of all the ridiculous juvenile notions.
You mock me, but just imagine, a world in which traffic jams and car crashes are a thing of the past.
Well, I might be more inclined to listen to you if your maiden voyage hadn't ended in a crash on one roof and a stranded dog on another.
I'm working on getting him down. Einie, how'd you get down? Clever dog.
Well, fortune favors you tonight, but I warn you to be more careful in the future.
Now, how to get that rocket car back down?
Hey, boy, take a whiff of this. Gotta love that nose.
I've been laying low, officer, but I've gotta go to the pictures once in a while.
Hello, Arthur.
Officer?
I'll take it from here.
But...
We can talk at the Majestic, away from prying eyes.
Yeah, Einstein, you done good. Hey, Doc, I could use a little help.
What's the problem?
Is Artie still here?
He's in the bathroom.
Hey, Artie, open up. You've got a gangster to bring down.
Is it time for me to meet this Sylvia?
No, it's time for you to meet Trixie.
Trixie says she's got something that might be able to send Kid up the river, but that you're the only one she trusts to check it out.
Me? What is she... Oh, I know what she's done. Clever.
Care to let us in on the secret?
Sorry, guys, but if Trixie's keeping it a secret, then so am I.
That's all well and good, Mr. McFly, but if you and Trixie are going to collaborate on this evidence, we'll need to arrange a rendezvous.
Well, Trixie's chained to Kid's speakeasy.
So we'll have to bring Arthur to Trixie.
Uh-uh. No way am I getting anywhere near that place again. I don't know how you talked me into this.
Just stay back here in the shadows and don't come out until you see Trixie.
You're sure I'll be safe here?
Perfectly safe. We'd never make you take any unnecessary...
Sagan. Where's Kid?
Don't worry.
Welcome back, sir.
What's it gonna take to get Trixie to squeal on Kid? Trixie?
Yeah?
Guess who's waiting in the alley to talk with you?
Huddy?
The one and only. It wasn't easy to track him down. I had
to... Cover for me, cue ball. I'm taking a smoke break.
Atta girl.
Hey, you!
Huh?
Yeah, jerk! I saw you making eyes at my Eunice!
Sorry, pal. I don't have time for a fight.
Why, you!
I'll never get to Carnegie Hall at this rate.
All right, fella. I think you're done for the night. Hey, where do you think you're going?
Me?
Yeah, you.
What do you know about this?
Nothing.
Trixie?
Breaks over, Q-Ball.
Whatever you say, babe.
What was that? Trixie?
Yeah?
What happened in the alley with Arthur?
I don't want to talk about it.
Break a leg out there.
Thanks.
Artie?
You missed a hell of a party, buddy.
Kid, well, what happened?
Oh, you're gonna love this. So I'm hanging out in the club when all of a sudden I get an urge to drain the lizard, right? I come out into the alley, and who do I see? None other than that scrawny, subpoena-answering rat, Artie McFly. And get this! The little worm's whispering away all conquistadorial-like with my Trixie!
Oh, no.
Naturally, I pull out Kid Jr. and prepare to put a couple bullets in McFly's head, which causes Artie's nose to start bleeding because he's a big wuss. And then... and then...
What?
Trixie literally gets down on the knees and begs me to let him live!
Huh?
Seriously, down on her knees crying and begging for McFly's life.
So, what did you do?
What could I do? I fired 2 shots in the air and told Artie to take a hike.
Huh, that was merciful.
Hey, I got plenty of mercy. Besides, now Trixie owes me big time. And Kid Tannen always collects on his debts. Always.
Welcome back, sir.
What's it gonna take to get Trixie to squeal on Kid? You think you could draw a picture of this guy?
Sure. Hey, that looks like that Artie McFly fink.
I never noticed that before. Hey, can you give him a hat like Artie wears?
Voila!
Nice job.
Now, go tell them chumps at the New Yorker.
You in?
Why not?
I'm happy, go lucky, and say I am plucky, so jolly.
Even's my lucky number.
I don't care if I do get the
21.
This isn't my game.
If I'm never successful, it won't be distressful, cause I don't care. News, it's rage. I'm overflowing. I've asked my doctor and psychiatrist too. They tell me that there's not a thing I can do. There's no consoling and there's no control.
Hey kid,
what is it, Squirt?
It's a nice place you got here,
ain't it? I picked out all the statuary myself when I was traveling through Greece.
I can tell it's got that Tannen touch.
Thanks.
Trixie really begged for Artie's life?
Yeah, that's what I get for letting him tutorate her. She's gone soft on the little bug.
See ya, kid.
Yeah, whatever.
There's something that I've got to get off my chest. It's rage. I'm overflowing with rage. I'm like a villain on a stage. You're a lion in a cage full of rage. I'm overflowing with rage.
Thank you.
Every morning, every evening, Hank, we got fun. Not much money, oh, but honey, Hank, we got fun. The rent's unpaid, dear, we haven't a box. But smiles were made, dear, for people like us. In the winter, in the
sorry
summer,
about this, Dad.
Don't we have fun? Times are bum and getting bummer, still we have fun. There's nothing surer.
You in?
The rich get rich and the poor get children. In the meantime, in between
double zero.
Time, egg, we got fun.
Two.
Come to me, my melancholy baby. Cuddle up and don't be blue. All your fears are foolish fancy, maybe.
Danny,
you know, you. Dear, that I'm in love.
So about
with
those
you.
Troubles.
It all started on June 14th. I was chasing down one of Tannen's boys when this car, straight out of Buck Rogers, popped up out of nowhere and ran my car off the road.
No.
Then later, I lost track of a witness. A Porsche love hasn't been heard from since.
That wasn't your fault.
And then, to top it off, I somehow managed to lose custody of an 80-year-old arsonist. When not one, but two of those godforsaken space cars showed up and whisked him away.
That's unbelievable.
That's what the chief said. Demoted me on the spot. My family sent me to a psychiatrist because they thought I was seeing things. And worst of all, my gal Betty left me because she thinks I'm a bad provider and a head case.
Betty? As in Jennifer's grandma Betty?
What?
Listen, Danny, it's really important that you get back together with Betty.
Oh, that ship sailed. But the heck with her. I got a little secret that'll set me up with women twice as classy as Betty'll ever be.
You've got a secret? What is it?
I don't think I should tell you. When I'm sad like this, I don't think straight. But listen.
Yes?
I like you. You're my new best friend.
See you later, Danny.
I'll be here.
That secret.
Oh, yeah. My secret. Well, you're my pal. Well, I can tell you, but don't let it get out. I've been working for Tannen for over a month now.
What?
It's true. All I gotta do is look the other way while evidence is getting destroyed or a truck full of gin is coming across the county line, and Tannen makes sure an extra bunch of bills makes their way into my pay envelope. Great deal, huh?
No, not a great deal.
What's the problem? People need to drink, right? As long as no one's getting hurt, why shouldn't Daniel J. Parker make a few bucks on the action?
But people are getting hurt. Kid's a killer.
Ah, that's just rumors and circumnavigational evidence. Although, that wall of fame is pretty spooky. Oh, God. I've made a horrible mistake. I thought if I could get my hands on some money, that Betty'd take me back. But when she finds out what I'd done, she'll never even talk to me again. What have I done?
Come on, Danny, pull yourself together. It's not so bad.
Not so bad? I'm a corrupt cop who's lost his only chance at true love. How's that not so bad?
Hang in there, Danny.
Oh, God.
You should care what people think of you.
She's right. I can turn my life around.
Sure you can.
You know what? I used to be a good cop. And yeah, I've had a few bad breaks. Possibly even a psychotic one that caused me to imagine a disappearing space car. But I'm a good man.
Yeah.
And all I need to do to win Betty back is be the same good man I always was. And let the chips fall where they may.
All right. So, now what?
Now I wait. Wait for the moment to take down Kid Tannen, restore my good name, and win back the heart of Betty Lipinski.
Hold that thought. I bet that moment is just around the corner.
Boss?
Do you mind? I'm trying to have a good time here.
I think you'll want to see this.
Are you crazy? Bringing a stick of dynamite into my club?
That's just it, boss. It's all over the place. I think our speakeasy arsonist is getting ready to strike again.
You in?
I'm going to play 7, 23, and 30. I wonder where this leads.
Welcome back, sir.
What's it gonna take to get Trixie to squeal on Kid? Trixie?
Yeah?
I don't know how to tell you this, but I think you should check out the Wall of Fame.
Why? What is it? Artie! I don't believe it! We had a deal. Artie was supposed to be safe.
I don't know what to say.
Well, I do. Felony tax evasion.
What?
Before he died, Artie was teaching me about all sorts of stuff. Literature, history, accounting. And I made a big discovery while I was copying all of Kid's books. This establishment ain't entirely on the up and up.
Really?
Oh, I knew about all the gangster stuff. That kind of thing you expect from tough guys like Kid. But when I found out he ain't been paying taxes on his speakeasy profits, well, cheating Uncle Sam is one step over the line. Once I turn this over to the police, they'll throw the book at him. This book! Hey, copper! What happened to my louse of an ex-boyfriend?
I don't know.
Rats. I told the chief we need a team of bloodhounds like they got over in Placerville. Yeah, but in the meantime...
All right, everyone, party's over. Everyone out of the speakeasy.
Speakeasy? You're mistaken, officer. This is an ice cream parlor.
Nice try, you. Out!
Corleone. Would the Valenti mob be willing to help, defuse this little situation?
I don't know. The Valenti mob doesn't like being associated with losers.
Hey, we ain't begging here. Kid just thought JJ might like a piece of the action. Especially now that he's just caught the speakeasy arsonist.
Wait, you mean... Doc?
Doc? You ain't with the Valenti gang at all, are you? What do you know about the arsonist?
Come on, you. Off to the station house.
Kid's gonna get you, rat. He's gonna get all of you.
Yeah. Well, that's that. Thanks to Miss Trotter's evidence, the entire Hill Valley police force is out looking for Kid and his goons.
You don't understand. We've got to find him now. He's captured a friend of mine.
Who?
Never mind.
Don't worry. We've got the entire town square sealed off. If Tannen's within a mile of here, we'll find him eventually.
I don't think we have time for eventually. Irving Kid Tannen. Guess he dropped this on his way out. It's empty. Figures. Hey, boy, how you doing? Good dog. Hey, Einie, get your nose over here. All right. I really don't think Tannen and Doc are with Herbert Hoover, Einie. Okay, I'll check it out. A button. All right, Doc. Here I come.
Corleone! What are you doing here? Never mind. Come here and help me get rid of this stinking arsonist.
Edna?
I caught her planting dynamite while he was clearing out the soup kitchen. Guess Sagan was innocent after all.
I was researching a story, you ignoramus!
Tell it to St. Peter, sister.
Hey, what's all this?
Parker!
Tannen, you're under arrest.
Get him, Sacramento boy.
I can't do that, kid.
What? Oh, I get it.
Why don't you let go of Miss Strickland and call it a night?
Hey, look over there! Watch out!
Give it up, Tannen. The alley's blocked off and so are the roads out of town. It's over.
Over? Nothing is over until Kid Tannen says it's over. Tannen! Make like a tree and die, rat!
Make it easy on yourself, Tannen!
Tannens never make things easy! Hey, kid!
Eat lead, phony!
More on this! Yo, Tannen! Make like a tree and die, rat! Hey!
Atta girl.
No one messes with Kid Tannen!
Oh!
Come on, kid. You know how this'll end.
Bowling for Tannen. Hey, kid!
That ain't a real gun.
Oh, right. I forgot. I better just get rid of it then.
Oh, crap.
Hey, he's getting away!
Oh, no.
Yes! No. There! Good as new!
Oh, look!
Tannen!
The judge's son! All right, Parker! I want a getaway car and a clear road to Nevada, or the brown kid gets it!
Doc!
Marty!
Doc?
Yes, it's me!
I'm talking to you through the radio apparatus my younger self has installed in the rocket car. What's going on up there?
It's not good, Doc. Trixie and Parker did their part, but now Kid's holding you hostage.
Great Scott!
No kidding.
Try to get Kid in the car. Once he's inside, give me a signal, and I'll do the rest.
How am I?
You!
Emmett!
You're the cause of all of this, ain't you? Should have known. What kind of gangster's named Michael Corleone?
Yeah, well, what kind of gangster's named Irving?
Hey! Doc, hit it! What the hell? Woohoo! Sing it! All right!
That's what you get from messing with Carl Sagan!
Irving Tannen, I'm placing you under arrest for kidnapping, attempted murder, tax evasion, and smelling like a piece of crap.
Tax evasion?
Haven't you heard? The feds are practically drooling over Trixie's books.
Trixie?
That's what you get for killing Artie, you bastard!
What? I didn't...
Trixie?
Artie?
All right, Grandpa.
My poor car.
I believe I owe you an apology, Mr. Brown. Thanks to your ridiculous contraption, Hill Valley's most notorious criminal is finally headed to prison.
No apologies necessary, Miss Strickland. My rocket car may have accidentally saved the day, but only because it's a completely out-of-control failure. I need a new idea.
If you're willing to listen, I might have a few suggestions.
But first, I think we should take in a movie.
I'm all yours, Mr. Brown.
I think you'll like it. It's all about a brilliant scientist with an overabundance of hubris.
Whew. Come on, Einie. Let's go find Doc. Thanks for letting me fly the DeLorean, Doc. This thing's a blast.
Are you absolutely sure that everything's back to normal?
Totally. Kid's going to jail, Emmett's going to see Frankenstein, and there's no such thing as a Tannen crime family in 1986. And we remembered Einstein this time, too.
Hill Valley crime rate at all-time low.
Well, except for Grandpa necking with Trixie, I think we're ready to go back to 1986.
Do you feel yourself fading out of existence?
No.
Then as long as your father's still born in 7 years, I say, let your grandfather sow his oats.
Sowing oats? Is that what's going on with you and Edna?
What are you talking about?
Emmett and Edna. They're gonna go see Frankenstein together.
That's odd. Great Scott!
What?
Gotta get back in. Stop the car. This could be disastrous.
Doc!
Ah!
Where'd you go, Doc?
Relax! We've got everything under control.
Doc?
Martin McFly, age 18.
Okay, Doc, let's see what kind of nightmare alternate timeline I've landed in this time.
Father George, Mother Lorraine.
Hill Valley under Citizen Brown is not quite the contented town you were led to believe it was.
A re-education program? What the hell?
Please don't swear, Martin. It makes me uncomfortable.
Zero demerits until this morning.
We're through, McFly. I'll never date such a square again.
My own girlfriend thinks I'm a square?
The obvious question, Mr. McFly, is... what happened to you?
Jesus Christ, Doc, what happened to you?